This topic today is how much liver can we live without? It's kind of a weird question. So let's just say, how much liver do you need to function normally? How much liver do we really need to maintain normal liver function? And this is pretty bizarre because you only need 25%. So the liver is really robust. And apparently we have about 75% of the liver that acts as a buffer, and we can live without that if necessary. Of course, it's not the ideal situation, but we actually don't need much liver to maintain normal liver function. Now, this is good and bad news, because sometimes people think, wow, I can pretty much eat what I want because I don't need much of my liver, so I'm just going to push the envelope and ride the wave, and then when I need a new liver, I'll just get a transplant. Well, that's one way to look at things. I don't think it's probably the best way because there's a transplant list that you have to get on, which takes a long time. But as a plan B, they do have another option. It's called living liver donation. So you just talk your friend or family member into donating some of their liver, like 50% of the liver. So then that way you actually can get a transplant. It's a little bit different because you're not getting the whole liver, you're getting partial liver, and it has to regrow back. But that comes with two problems. Number one, you have to find a friend or a family member which has the same blood type as you do, and they're willing to give it up. Now, the other problem you might run into is that you might have to take anti-liver rejection drugs. So there's usually antibodies that are going to develop, that are going to attack this new liver. They involve usually steroids, so you have to take those. They have side effects. But if you can overcome those side effects, what's very fascinating is that the liver can regenerate at an accelerated rate. Most of the liver regeneration will occur in 2 to 4 weeks after getting this transplant, which is amazing. The liver is the only visceral organ that can regenerate. It takes a beating and it just keeps coming back. Now, you probably have seen some of my other videos on YouTube, and I always like to just give you some important tips to maintaining liver function, just because some people need to be reminded over and over and over. Number one, you want to avoid the triggers that will cause liver damage in the first place. Of course, alcohol, junk food, sugar are all at the top of the list. Number two, you want to establish a new eating plan. And I'm talking about healthy keto. Now, I actually have a book that describes the 4 body types. And the diet that you would most benefit from would be the diet for the liver body type. So you can actually look at that. Intermittent fasting is going to be essential for the reduction of inflammation, also the stimulation of stem cells that will help you regenerate liver tissue. There are also some really important key nutrients that you need to take. Vitamin D, roughly about 20,000 IUs to keep your inflammation really low, because it's really the inflammation that creates the damage from liver problems in general. Tocotrienols, which is a type of vitamin E, which is very important in preventing a fatty liver developing into an inflamed liver, which eventually develops into a fibrotic liver or a liver with scar tissue. Bile salts are really important. As you lose liver function, you also lose your ability to make bile. So by taking bile salts, you can also help slow down the fibrosis in the liver, because bile salts are anti-fibrotic. And the last thing, take probiotics. There's a huge connection between your microbes in your gut and liver function. I did an entire video on this. I'll put a link down below. All right, there you have it. And that's all I have to say about the liver today. Thanks for watching.
Before you go, if you have a question about a product, or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the US. Hopefully in the future we'll be able to answer everyone's call. But I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.